In this video, we're out here, we're on the golf course, real golf course setting, real golf ball, premium ball, FlightScope Mevo. We're lasering everything off. We're gonna hit some drives. Let's see what we get outdoors, what's really going on. Hey everybody, Scott Ogan coming at you. We are here at Inwood Golf Course. We're on the beautiful 16th hole here. Great driving hole, one that I really wanted to go for because there's a couple of reasons, we'll go over those. But again, if you're not a subscriber, make sure you click that subscribe button, tune into the channel, answering any questions and all questions about the Mevo Plus, helping you with your golf game. Make sure you don't miss out on that. So make sure you click that subscribe button. Today, we are on the 16th hole here at Inwood. So why do I like this hole? One, it's a good driving hole. Obviously a very narrow start here. You gotta go through the shoot of trees. Then it does dogleg hard left, but we're not gonna worry about that right now. What I like is through the fairway, there is some trees. Now we have got it shot off from our hitting point at 244 yards to those trees. So we're gonna use that as our point. We're gonna hit some drives, see where we get to, try to do our best to eyeball it from here, seeing where we land. But we're gonna get out there and just check out what we get on numbers, see what we got, okay? So got everything set up, going with the phone for the setup, doing the environmental mode, all that stuff. So we'll have all that going, and we've got it set for the direction. Let's see what we get. All right, so we are set up to go. I am doing outdoor mode. I'm using my phone so I could set the weather conditions for this, and we're gonna see what we got. So going right at these two trees, the tree on the left is the main target. That's right over our dirt patch. It's 244 to that tree. I just shot it with the laser. So, you know, again, I'm not at full strength, so I'm not trying to hit it a certain distance. I just want to see what we got. I got a reference point out there. So, see what we can do. Hit that pretty good. Just left of the tree, flew by it. Well, let's see, wasn't connected. So I think the big thing is I can't talk. Man, I wish I got that one. So no read on the first one because I shut it off. My phone went off actually. Hit that one pretty good too. It's just a touch left. Tell you what, getting annoyed with the phone. So that's something we're learning. My phone shuts off too fast. Blocked a little right. So that went right. Carry says 240, ball speed 151, 243 total distance, okay? So let's go take a look at that drive. We didn't get the first two because I had my phone went to sleep, so we might come back and try a couple more in a sec, but let's go out there, let's take a look. All right, so we're out here in the fairway, so let's take a look, okay? So here's the golf ball that we just hit, the third one. Again, the first two didn't read my phone. I gotta get my phone off power mode. So I'll go back and redo them. But here's that tree we shot. That is 244. So it said it, here, let me read you the stats. All right, let me read you the stats. We had 239 carry, launch was 15, that's pretty good. 243 total. So it says it's 244 to that tree. Here's the ball a little past it, but a little to the right. So it's probably cut off a few yards by being a little right. And it's probably, I mean, that's pretty close. That's pretty close. And that's even with the downwind, it's picking that up. So, you know, actually better than I was expecting. So, I, you know, from what I've been hearing with other people's issues on the units. So, there we go. We gotta hit a few more drives. I'm gonna go grab these again and let's hit a few more because we wanna get those first ones put. So far, so good. It said the spin rate was 2,800. That's pretty good. Yeah, that seems about right. For me, that was a little bit of a high right spinny shot. It's gonna have a little more spin. I'm usually around 2,300. That's where I like to be. That seems to be my best place. So there we go.
and we'll round them up. Let's do it again.
All right, so fun fact, we're gonna have two more golf balls here. I was out there grabbing the other ones and somebody came over and hit the ball, and they claim they're also at one of these, but I can't find mine, so who knows. But we're back. All right, so again, it's 244 to that tree straight ahead. I've got everything, says it's ready. Let's go. Let's try not to hit a fade. Pretty good one there, fairly straight. Little tail to the right, but hit a little stronger. Okay. Kind of tough to tell, I'm learning. Direction's good, direction was good. Smash seems right, and because it was a higher, spinnier shot, it says it was at 2,900. So we'll show you that. Yeah, that's kind of what it did. Let's get a second one in here. I'm really trying to draw one. I can, just don't have it right now. There we go, that was the best one anyway. Get it, oh, it got it. Sweet. You know, it actually did a pretty good job. That ball started a little left and then it tailed back to the right. It's actually showing that on the graph here. 252 carry, I did swing a little faster, 109, 256 total. Let's see, spin rate, 2,800, a little spinny. And it does look like my contact's a little on the bottom, so I guess that's possible. So, all right, let's go take a look, see how it did. All right, so here we are. This is the first drive we just hit on this second set, right here. That's the tree that's 244. That's the one straight ahead. You know, we're off to the right. I peeled that one off pretty far to the right, which we did see on here. And it says the carry was 238, total yards 242. That's 244. If I took this in a circle over there, that's pretty close if you ask me. It did have the spin axis correct. You know, the launch angle makes correct. The spin rate makes correct, it seems correct. Actually might be a touch low, if anything, but seems okay. Again, we are downwind a little, but it had that part right. It had it as a fade. It read the shot correctly. It started a little right and went right. So far, ball number one, I'd say pretty much in the ballpark. Is as good as you can expect, I would say. Let's go check out the second one. All right, so here is that last ball we hit. So let's get our numbers out. It did properly classify it as a pull fade. I was aiming straight at the tree. I pulled it and it started fading back. So I was excited about that. Let's read you some numbers. The carry was 252. So it's saying it just landed just past the tree. And then it's saying it ran out to 256. So let's just shoot. Let's see. The 256, it didn't definitely ran out more than that. But let's see. I've got 26 yards to that tree. So I'm at 270 right now, right? So it's missing about 14 yards of roll. But again, if we're going carry, if I had to guess, you know, if I'm at 270, if I, you know, did I get 18 yards of roll on this tee shot? I think I might've. It's downwind, it's a little firm, we haven't had a ton of rain. I think it might be pretty close. So again, it is definitely making sense to me. Is it something I can use and get a general idea of how far I'm carrying the ball right now? I think so. I think I definitely could do that. And is it showing me where the ball's starting relative to my start line? It sure did. I mean, that makes sense. So far so good. I think maybe testing it out, seeing a little bit more, I'd like to do that, but on a flat tee box with a good setup, a good sight line, so far so good. I think maybe the golf balls help a little bit. These are those TP5 picks, which I really like anyway, but they might be seeing that one pretty good. Maybe that's part of it too, I don't know, but I'd be interested to see a couple other golf balls out there that people play. So seeing that on course, real golf ball. I think so far so good. All right guys, so that is our test FlightScope Mevo Plus on course, real golf ball, you know, real golf course setting. What are your thoughts? I used again the phone with the eco mode or the environment mode, sorry, not eco mode, where we started looking at having the humidity in there, having everything factored in. So maybe that's a big help and something you should look at as you're going outside. Maybe that makes this a little bit better, but I think so far, you know, in my opinion, for me, it's working out pretty good. I definitely think I could work with it and get better. Could we practice a little more and see? For sure. I mean, it was only a few shots, but we could try it out a little bit more.
I would be interested to see what other people get. I know a lot of people have been using outside with range balls. Range balls, you know, they are not very good. They knock off a good 20%, 15% off of the flight of a shot. So if you're hitting it to, you know, if you're hitting it 300, that's gonna knock off 45, 50 yards. So think about it from that if you're somebody out there using your range launch monitor on the range and seeing those shots. But, you know, heck, so far so good. Post any questions you have down below. Anything else you want us to try out here on course, and happy to set it up and give it a go and help you with your decisions and your questions about the unit. But again, so far so good. Make sure to click that subscribe button if you're not a subscriber already, and we will see you in the next video. All right, everybody, peace.